The next step is to paint that tractor. I love tractors, and it's really interesting. My collectors must too, because this is the second John Deere tractor that I have painted in a painting in the last about 8 months. So they're popular with my collectors. And that's the fun of doing commissions. I get to paint things that normally I wouldn't paint. So I love collaborating with my clients on their paintings and capturing their dreams on canvas. So that's one of the great things about being an artist. So here goes on our John Deere tractor. The sun will be just tipping over this building and catching this edge of the tractor. I may have that a little too green. I'll come back and make adjustments if I have to. This is a mix of ultramarine blue plus phthalo blue plus lemon yellow. Get that John Deere tractor green. And again, this is in the distance, so it's not going to be super detailed, but we do need to get the shape right. Anybody that knows tractors will know if I've got it right or not. So. And that the wheels and back of the tractor is actually going to be casting a shadow over this part of the front of the tractor. And then the engine, part of the engine shows here, so we just, I'm using, again, that's my mud plus liquid to make that little area. And then the top of the tractor, the front of the tractor, catches the most light because, again, it's flat. So we're going to just pull a little light on that. Now I've got that, don't quite have the angle right, so I'm going to come back in with my dark. Just lower that. And the stack I've got too tall, I'm just going to go ahead and paint that out, and then I'll paint it over. Mainly had it there at that point just to remind myself to put that in. So I'm going to get a smaller brush. And the stack on the John Deere tractor is also that green, that signature green. It comes up from about this point. So. Well, I can't seem to draw that down straight. That's really too fat. So I just take my dark, get a little thinner. Still don't have the angle. I don't quite have it straight up and down, but I can come back in and make adjustments. Again, I have my reference over to my right side where I can just look at it. The steering wheel is actually not green, but I'm gonna have to cheat so we can see it. I'll let the sunlight kind of glance off of it. Just the light's catching just the top of the steering wheel. Got that front of the tractor a little too thick right there, so I just, again, I can come back with my dark. Make that a little bit thinner. The tractor tractor's just parked right in front of this little outbuilding. One of those wheels is going to be on that, the other wheel is on that side, so that gives us a real good dark in there. The inner part of the wheel, I guess the hub, I'm not exactly certain what you'd call that, but it's yellow. So I'm going to make a very muted yellow with cadmium yellow medium plus ultramarine plus, no, not. Let me start over here. I got tongue twisted. My yellow is cadmium yellow medium plus mud, which is my ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson. I don't want it to be a bright yellow because I don't want it to jump forward of my building and stuff back up here. I just want that to fall back into the distance. I'm actually just using a little mud right now to give the feeling of that wheel, shape of the wheel. And then the hub's going to be just like, well, it's not quite light enough. There's my tractor. I've got to do the front hubs also are yellow. We just want to give the feeling of that tractor back there. It's not going to be real detailed. It's just very impressionistic. I have that steering wheel. Now let's do the yellow hubs for the front wheels. And this other one is, the inside of that I don't think is yellow, so we're just going to make it dark. I may have to just cheat a little bit. I don't know if it's yellow or not, so we're just going to make it a dark yellow. And then the hub. I'll make this a little bit darker in here. This is just again, this is very, very loose. I just want to get the feeling of this tractor back there. Some green coming down in between to the axle. Goes down to the axle there. My steering wheel is just a little too far forward, so I just take some of my dark and move it back. Want that wheel to stand out. So what I'm going to do is we have blue bonnets coming back here. A few little blue bonnets, or this is going to be kind of sitting in the blue bonnets. And I'll come back and do a little more work on these blue bonnets. But the tractor's just sitting in blue bonnets. It's the height of springtime. And we're kind of cheating because we're having spring, and our corn is also in the tassel stage, which would actually be later in the summer, but that's the joy of painting, is you can kind of cheat. Things don't grow at exactly the same times. Who cares in a painting? We want the corn to have tassels on it, so we just will, and we'll have blue bonnets at the same time. So I appreciate you following along. Please feel free to ask questions. You can always write them in the comments section of my YouTube video. Thank you, and you have a great day.